the heart has very specific electrical pathways, essentially electrical wiring. Very similar to what you would have in a house. The impulse goes down those electrical wires, and those wires basically plug into the different cells of the heart. And when the impulse gets to those cells, it depolarizes them. In a sense, it gives them a little jolt, and this causes the cell to contract. And ultimately, this causes the heart to contract and pump the blood into the remainder of the body. It's very important for the heart to have a very uniform and consistent rhythm. Just as in a house you could have a room that has faulty electricity, when you turn on the switch, instead of getting light, you get a light bulb that flickers, you could get short-circuiting in different chambers of the heart. And what that manifests as is a racing or an irregularity in the electrical function of the heart. This is what an arrhythmia is. It is a disturbance in the electricity of the heart. A short circuit in the lower chambers of the heart can cause the heart to race very, very fast, up to the point that the heart can suddenly stop. There are also arrhythmias that occur in the upper chambers of the heart, but instead of being localized to one location, there are multiple different circuits all going on at the same time. And this is what atrial fibrillation is. The symptoms primarily involve palpitations, feeling that the heart is skipping, feeling that the heart is very erratic. Often they involve feeling very tired and fatigued and unable to do regular activities. And therefore, it becomes important to alleviate the symptoms and improving the quality of life. The advent of ablation procedures for atrial fibrillation has really revolutionized the field. We go in with catheters through the vein into the heart. The catheter has a magnetic tip. It allows us to detect electricity, so we're able to measure through the tip of that catheter where those short circuits are. We can localize them and then cauterize them. We take a lot of pride at Yale in refining our technology and our techniques for the management of atrial fibrillation. And it really has been a great ride. It's been nothing but revolutionary in terms of our ability to treat arrhythmias, to restore normal rhythm in cases that in the past we would never have dreamed that we'd be able to.